Hey everyone, so I wanted to share how I do potty, the potty setup for Teddy. So a lot of you had asked me to do a video on this, and that's why I'm doing it. So there are just five key points really quickly with, you know, potty training and just being, you know, doing this whole potty setup. It's, you know, be consistent, be patient, be positive, limit space, and make sure you have good cleaning products. So in terms of this particular setup, I purchased a dog potty pan for Teddy. you can, you know, I got this one, I think, 6 years ago. And I think you can try Googling online. But they should still have these. I think they're a slightly different style now. But, you know, I bought this dog potty pan. Some people, I guess, put sort of like litter in there that's for the dogs, but I haven't tried that. What I just do is I put a diaper pad in there, and I just leave the potty pan in one place, and that's what I mean by being consistent. So always keep the potty space or spot in the same place. I put a diaper pad down in the potty pan, and then I also put down one in the front. And the reason being is because when they go to the bathroom, you know, with all these pads, they still do track, you know, their paws track the urine when they come out because they sometimes inevitably step in it or they're going on it. So, I keep a potty pad out in front. That way when he pops out, you know, he tracks on that and I don't get, you know, little urine marks over the rest of the house. The other thing I do is, sometimes, and I can show you in just a second. So this is the other thing I can do, to save the pad. So, you know, obviously if you have one pad, you know, they may not want to go back in there. Some of them are kind of picky about being clean, so they may not want to go in. So this is what I do. And this is obviously for someone who, you know, is home or they're not, the dog isn't left for many hours. So I put the potty pads on like this. So I drape them over the sides. And this is good because what you can do is then when they go in the middle, you can just flip the sides around and around until maybe you get soiling on all four sides. And so in essence, you know, you could have the dog going like eight times on just two pads, which can help save money and also help save the environment. So an important thing to do is make sure that you get a pee-pee pad that attracts the dog to the pad. So the one that I use is I get it at PetSmart, and it's a brand called Top Paw. And I have found it to be the best in terms of attracting the dog to the spot, and then also, you know, it's a pretty good absorbent, at least in my opinion. So that's the pad that we use. And so going back to what I was saying before, you know, about being consistent, you know, the dog is generally going to go at certain times. So, you know, in the morning, you know, it's like after they've eaten or first thing in the morning, first thing in the morning, they'll want to go. And then after they've eaten and drank, they'll want to go. So anytime they drink water or they're playing, that sort of gets, you know, their internal organs moving, and so they want to go to the bathroom after that. So, you know, just be aware, like, during those times, you know, if you're trying to teach your dog to potty, like, those are the times that they're going to be interested in wanting to go, so those are the times that you might want to work on teaching them to go potty. So, how I teach Teddy to go potty is he will potty on command. He's pretty good about this. And that's because I use positive reinforcement. So positive reinforcement is another key part of potty training. So you never want to scold the dog, you know, if they've had an accident. 100% of the time, if the dog has an accident, I hate to say it, but it is the owner's fault. And don't feel bad about that because, you know, it happens. You know, you always want to set up a situation where the dog is not going to fail, you know? And so it's very important to be positive with the dog, treating the dog, you know, using keywords. So I'm going to give an example now. Teddy, go potty, 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 go potty. Yes! Good job! Good job! And so the first thing you can't see because he's out of the video right now, but I gave him a bunch of little green peas. So a key part in doing the training is having this positive reinforcement. So you just saw how that worked out. You know, when he's going to the bathroom or I want him to go to the bathroom, I'll tell him the keywords. And then while he's going, I keep saying, go potty. The second he's finished, I use, you know, a special word that he knows is tied to treats. And I use the word yes. The second I say yes, I gotta treat him. And then he ties that to the word and he knows he's done something great. And, you know, he's all excited and he's happy. So when they do a great job, you gotta act like, you know, they won the lottery or something or won a game of bingo. You know, go crazy and tell them how great they are and get all excited. So that's something else to mention in terms of, you know, positive reinforcement. So another key thing with potty training is being patient. As I said before, you're going to have accidents, you know, especially when you first start out training, and sometimes even later, you know, that you may have accidents. And, you know, and as I said before, it's one of those things where it's really not the dog's fault. If you think about it, it's like, what did you do, you know, or what could have potentially led to it? Now, of course, sometimes things, you know, could be medically related. Maybe the dog has a UTI or something. I'm not talking about those situations. I'm talking about just behavioral training. So, you know, a lot of things that I will see, you know, sometimes in these Yorkie groups on Facebook is people are saying, my dog used to be so great and now he's going to the bathroom all over the house. Well, here's the thing, you know, if you let your dog all over the house, that can happen. So the important thing to do is, you know, going back to step one and limiting the space. So that's another key point in potty training is limiting space. So, and this is where this playpen comes in handy. So this one is by Seabreeze. I think it's Seabreeze Playpens or Seabreeze Kennels. I can't remember, but I'll link it down below. And I think this one is an 8-foot pen. And you can see this one has, you know, little, you know, I can't remember what these are called, but they have these metal attachments. So you can pull it together and actually make a circle. So what I would say is if you have a dog that's soiling, you know, all over the house, and especially if you have carpet, you know, you really do want to limit the dog to a certain space. And you could put up a playpen and you can line it with a potty, you know, pad, and you can also have his bed in there. So this is not supposed to be like a permanent thing, but, you know, it's telling the dog, you know, hey, I can't trust you. And, you know, this is the best thing for the dog until, you know, you're able to slowly open up the space again. So, obviously this is not one of those things where you want to leave the dog in there for hours. If you can't watch the dog, this is, you know, what you can do. You know, but part of potty training is really watching the dog. So if they look like they're going to go, like they're going to circle, because they usually make these telltale signs of circling and sniffing. And as I said before, like, you know, they tend to go to the bathroom after certain times of the day. So, you know, just be aware of the signals. And so the thing is, if you can't, you know, if you can't watch the dog like a hawk or you can't, you know, carry him around, then I think the best thing to do really is to put them in the playpen. And the reason I like this playpen is it's not heavy. It's made out of plastic. Of course, if you have a bigger Yorkie and they're leaning up against it, I'm not so sure how well it will stay up. But Teddy's 7 pounds, and, you know, when I close this all up, it doesn't fall over generally. So the last point that I wanted to make about potty training is it's important to get a really good cleaner. So when they do have mistakes, it's important to get a cleaner that you know will really take the smell away. The reason they keep going, sometimes I see people complaining, oh, you know, they keep going to the same place. You know, it's because it wasn't cleaned up in such a way that the smell is gone. So the one that I use is this one, Nature's Miracle, and it's the Oxy Formula one. To be honest with you, I haven't used this much because when I first started training Teddy, I think he only had maybe 2 or 3 accidents in the house. And so this is the one that I use. Make sure you just soak down the area really well and just leave it. I mean, I leave it on for like maybe 10 minutes and then I will clean up the spot. And so that really helps, with, you know, the potty training. So the last thing I wanted to mention was, these grooming wipes, which are great, you know, for when Teddy does, you know, step in, you know, whatever he's, you know, the pee pad and his feet are still wet. I use these wipes and I buy them on Amazon. They're really great. They're hypoallergenic. So I don't worry when, even if I wiped his feet, that he's like licking them. So these are a great, way to just clean their paws and not worry about, you know, ingesting something that could be bad for them. And again, I just found these on Amazon and I'll link it below.